Oh.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great. My name is Kay. It's so lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I'm super excited to see the halftime show. Your music has honestly punctuated my last year of quarantine, so thank you.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
This past year has been daunting, to say the least. What does it mean to you to be performing on the biggest stage there is?
Oh, my God. It means everything. I mean, I haven't performed to an audience in years, so it's exciting to perform to a crowd, finally.
The big stars on Sunday on the field, and by now they have watched hours of tape and they have practiced. I want to know what kind of tape you've been watching. Which halftime performances inspire you the most?
I've been watching all of them, to be honest with you. I said it before that my favorite is Diana Ross's performance.
So does that mean you're leaving on a helicopter, or what's the deal?
I don't think they'll let me. I think she did it. It's like, after her, it's like you couldn't.
She retired the chopper for Super Bowl.
So I don't even think I would have been able to do it, to be honest. I don't know if you watched the VMA's performance, but there was helicopters around me and I was on the skyscraper. I was terrified.
So how did you get through that?
Like, I get through anything. I figure it out.
You've collaborated with some incredible artists over the years. I'm wondering, any chance we see a surprise guest pop up or fly in or hop on a pirate ship during the Super Bowl?
I've been reading a lot of rumors. I wouldn't bet on it. There wasn't any room to fit it in the narrative and the story I was telling in the performance. So yeah, there's no special guests.
You say story. I mean, you've revealed this character to us over the past year. Can you tell me who this character is?
Honestly, I have my answers, but I love people's theories and conclusions on who he is and what it means and the message he's giving.
Will the character make an appearance at Super Bowl halftime?
You have to see.
You're not gonna give me anything?
I gave you something.
Rumor has it you invested quite a bit of your own money into the halftime show. Tell me, what does $7 million buy you at Raymond James Stadium?
Well, honestly, it was tough to bring the vision to life with what we had at the time. You know, we really wanted to be safe. We really thought about the players and the workers. So we built the stage within the actual stadium. We'll still be using the field and other parts as well, too, but whatever it takes, you know?
Going through this process, what's been the toughest part for you?
Figuring out how to perform to potentially an empty stadium, potentially 20,000. We didn't really know what we were doing. We just knew that we'd have to be creative and figure it out. And I think, you know, Roc Nation made the right choice in picking me to bring something special to a situation like this.
What team do you want to see walk away victorious?
I'm not answering that. I plead the fifth.
No? Are you a Tom Brady fan?
Tom Brady's the homie. Love Tom Brady.
Okay, good. Have you met Tom Brady?
Not personally, but yeah, we've spoken.
You're more mysterious and secretive than the character who you've revealed and created.
I don't feel that mysterious right now.
Last one for you. What is on your warm-up list? What inspires you and gets you set before you take the stage?
James Brown. Me and the band just blast James Brown right before the performance, every show.
All of Tampa will be hearing that leading up to a brilliant, memorable, undeniable Super Bowl halftime show. Thanks.
Thank you, Kay. Bye.